Hello everyone, welcome to the next class on the topic evolutionary algorithm. Today we will discuss about how the Fireflies algorithm works for solving the optimization problem. Myself, Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can contact me by either of my email IDs if you feel any doubt, or you can browse this link for more updated videos. So in this video, I will explain the functionality of this Firefly algorithm with the help of this unconstrained optimization problem. So remember that if your problem is the constrained optimization problem, then if the problem is your constrained optimization problem, then you have to convert into the unconstrained optimization problem with the help of the penalty function, and then you can apply the Firefly algorithm. Otherwise, you can use the any other algorithms which we have already discussed so far regarding the PSO, ABC, Cuckoo Search, TLBO, etc. are there, SGO, and all these videos related to their workings are available in their description. So let's quickly overview what is the Firefly algorithms, and then we will explain it how it works. So this Firefly algorithm is initially developed by Professors Qin Xin Zhang in 2007 and 2008, which is presented in the form of the paper is with the title Firefly Algorithms for the Multimodal Optimization in 2009 here. So you can browse this link if you want to find more video, more updated information about the Firefly algorithm. And this Firefly algorithm is inspired by the flashing pattern or the behavior of the fireflies at the night. All of you know that what is a firefly. So look at that. If you remember, these are the fireflies, and this is just some light is there. So that's why this is the firefly. So when they move from one place to the another place, how they move and what the phenomena behind their movement is there. So that is described in this Firefly algorithm. So the Firefly algorithm is moved from the one place to another based on this equation. So this Firefly algorithm located at the any GA position, say this is a JTH position, this is the IH position, they can move either to this direction, either to this or to this, depending upon their attractiveness. So which has more attractiveness? What is the attractiveness here is fitness value f of x. So then the other fireflies located at xi will be moved toward the xj. So look at that. So this is the previous, this is my new position, that is we want to calculate. This xi is my old position. This is my constant. This is the towards xj, and this is initial position, or you can say the old position. And this small t, whatever is written here, this is called as the iteration count. So look at that. In this iteration counter are there. Now in this case, you can see that there are so many constants are there. One is a this, second is the gamma, second is the third is alpha, and the fourth one is epsilon. So what is the meaning of that? So the first one is epsilon, alpha. Alpha is called as the random parameter, and it lies between 0 to 1, and it control the randomness, or it control the stability of the algorithm. Alpha is called as the random number, which can be drawn either the Gaussian, uniform, Levy distribution, or any other are there. What about the beta 0? So in most of the case, this alpha t, it can be denoted as alpha 0 times delta, okay, or delta raised to power t. T is called as the iteration counter, where delta lies between 0 1, and for the most application it lies between 0.95 to 0.97. here alpha 0 is called as the initial randomness, or called as the scaling factor, and delta is called as the cooling factor is there. This beta 0, that is the this parameter, is called as the attractiveness parameter, and it control the attractiveness of the firefly. And in most of the calculation, we will set beta 0 as a 1, but if you want to change, you can change it as per your problem to problem. Now this alpha, as we know, this alpha t is defined like this way, okay, and this is called as the random number, which is drawn either from the uniform distribution or from the Gaussian distribution, called as the normal distribution also. or you can draw from the Levy distribution as we see in the cuckoo search, and etc. are there. So based on the initial alpha 0, simulation shows that the Firefly algorithm will be more efficient if alpha 0 is defined for the scaling. So what is the meaning of the scaling? So this says that if L is the average scale of the problem, the average scale of the problem is, if I have the problem having lower bound and the upper bound are there, so scaling is nothing but my range. This is my scaling. You can say this is a range. Lower and upper bounds are there. So then we will set as 1% of the scaling of the length, or you can set as a 2% depending on the problem. So what we study in this algorithm is, we will initially generate the random numbers, calculate the intensity. Intensity nothing but my fitness value. We will update the fireflies. We can use this, or else we can use the alpha t as alpha 0 of this. This is my random number. You can use any number of this. Once we will update this random number, we will perform the greedy selection. What is the greedy selection is? We will calculate the function value of the new and compare the function value with the old. If new is better than of the old, then we will update the solution, otherwise not be. So if termination criteria set, then we will get the optimal solution, otherwise we will calculate the fitness value again and then process move again and again. If you want to find the complete explanation of the Firefly's algorithms, then you can see the detailed description of this, which is available on my channel. That is here. You can simply browse on this. You will find the Firefly algorithm. Else you can browse this link on the description part. How many parameters are there which are associated with this Firefly? One is the population size. Second is the beta zero. Third is the absorption coefficient. Maximum number of the iterations. This alpha t is used for the here. So one is the alpha zero. Second is the delta. And it alpha is lies here. So, and you can find this video. So, in this, so explanation of this video is determined with the help of this function. So, this is any function, either can be polynomial or anything. The lower and upper bounds are there. So, we will, you can see the functionality of this same function. If you want to find, check the performance of this Firefly algorithm with the help of the other PSO, ABC, TLBO, social group and the cuckoo search, you can watch these videos which are available at again the same link here. Okay, so now we will set the parameters and we will start the working. So we will set the beta population size as a 5, number of the iterations as a 20, beta 0 as a 1. What is the beta 0 is? You can see beta 0 is my attractive coefficient. Gamma I can set as a 0.01. Alpha 0 as a 1, look at that, this is delta, is delta I set as a 0.97. you can set any number between 0.95 to 0.97. okay. So based on this we have to set this. So now, so the goal of this problem is, look at that, my objective function is how many decision variables? Only 2. So I have to construct this corresponding to x1, this corresponding to x2. So how we find? We will find the random number. What is the lower and upper bound of this problem is 5. So we will generate the random number L, that is a lower number. Any number which lies between 0 and 1, upper is 5, minus 5. So once you will substitute this value, you will get these numbers. For example, minus 5, any random number, say 0.313, upper is 5, this. Okay, so you will get minus 5 plus 0.313 of 10. So this is minus 5 plus 3.3. Okay, so you will get the one number which is called as the 1.87. So instead of any of this number, you will get 1.87. Similarly, this is called as the x1. This is for the x2. Once you are finding the value of this, because my population size I set as a 5, so that's why these are 5. Now we will calculate the fx. So what is the fx is here? This is the value of the x1. So firstly you take this x1 and this x2. You substitute here, you will get this answer. Similarly, for the second, you will get this, and so on. Now, in order to apply these Firefly algorithms, what we can do is we have to compare the each of the Firefly, that is function 1. So look at the for the first Firefly. What is the first Firefly? Is this. This is my first Firefly value, and my task is to minimize. I have compared this Firefly with the second. I have compared this with the third, fourth, and the fifth, one by one to the each populations. So let's start with the first one. So my task is to minimize. So what is the value of the F1 is 65.0885. What is the F2 is 37.1741. My task for the first Firefly, it means my task is to minimize F1. So is F1 is minimum? No, because F1 is greater than F2. So what is the meaning is that we will move the Firefly 1 towards the Firefly 2. Similarly, we can check Firefly 1 with the 2, but we will firstly perform this iteration. So once we will know that this condition, our target is this for the minimization. So since this does not satisfy, so we will move this equation. So look at that, this term. I have used, this is my expression. Alpha is denoted by this. This is a random number, so I generate the random number like this way. You can generate any type of the random number. This is my scale. Okay, why we use the scale is because otherwise the value of this can be lies outside the domain. Okay, so if it is lies outside the domain, then there it is addition of this, so again it lies outside the domain. So in order to make the balance, I define the scale, which is nothing but the upper minus lower bound. So let's start with this one. So in order to define this, we need the xi and the xj. So this, always remember xi towards xj. Okay, so what is my xi is first number. So this is my xi for the, and the second towards xj, j is my this, xi xj. Now I will firstly calculate the ri square. So you know the two vectors are there. So if I have x1, x2, y1, y2, then how you find the rij? Distance between them is, that is nothing but distance formula, Euclidean distance formula. This is there. Okay. So this is my x1, x2, y1, y2. So I can calculate here. Look at that. This minus this plus this minus this, you will get r as this. This is a term. Now, next part is x. This is already given to us. This is already given to us. This is already given. This is also given to us. Now, I calculate e raised power minus of this. Okay. So, I calculate this term. Beta 0 I define as a 1. Gamma I set as a 0.01. This is r square. So, r square is nothing but this. So, it gives you as a here. Now, I can calculate this part. R and D is my random number. Okay. So, alpha 0 is my 1. Delta is this. This time I take random number as a 0.37. Okay, this random number lies between 0 and 1. So you can take any one of them. Scale. So remember, what is my scale is? Upper bound minus lower bound. In this case, this what is upper bound is 5. Lower bound is minus 5. So what is that? This is 5 plus 5, 10. So look at alpha, scale is my 10. So after the calculation, you will get this number. Now this is complete term is there. So I can substitute this value all in here. You will get the new x1 and x2. So firstly, I will calculate x1. What is the x1 for the xi? This is the x1 for the first particle. Minus 4.5861 plus what is this parameter is? I have calculated as 8117. What is the xj? What is the xj of the x1 is? This number. Minus of this, so it's a minus minus plus, and this number is, look at that, this. So after calculation you will get this. So is it lies between minus 5 to 5? Yes, so it lies between minus 5 to 5. Similarly, you can calculate for the x2 by using this. What is the xi for the x2 is 3.9930 plus this number is same. xj is my 4.1747 and so on. So you will calculate this number as lift. So I have taken the R&D in this case also 0.37. If you take here as a 0.47, then this number will change. Then you have to change this. We will see in the couple of slides. Are there. Again, this number lies between minus 5 to 5. Now, so therefore, what is my x nu is? So x nu is my minus x1 and x2. So once we will calculate this x nu, we will perform the greedy selection. We will calculate the function value fx at this point. So this is my x1, this is my x2. I've calculated the value as, because what is my x1 is, fx is x1 x2 plus x2 square plus 2x1 plus 4x2 plus 3 is there. Okay, so you can substitute the value here as x1, this is x2, you will get this number. And what is the original fx is 65 point this, and my task is to minimum. So now check whether f nu, this is a new value, is less than of this, that is a better. So we will update x1. What is the meaning of the x1 is, we will delete this row, and in place of this we can write this value here, and in place of this we can write this value here. So look at that, this number. So minus 2.6270, 2.3945, look at that. So this is the for the f1. Now I can do the same thing for the f1 and f3. Now use the updated value f1, compare this f3. Okay, so my task is to minimize. So whether this hold, yes, this hold, because the number of this is less than of already this, so there is no need of the updation. So next one is, we will compare f1 and f4. So whether this is less than of this, no, this is greater than. So we will move the firefly one toward the fourth one. So we will move this toward the fourth. So what is my xi is? This is my xi. This is my xj. This is my xi. This is my xj. Then we will again calculate this. So we will firstly calculate the r. x1 this minus this minus this. So we will calculate here. Again, we will calculate this term, that is beta 0 of this, r is my this, I will calculate as 8259. Then the third one is, we will calculate this term. In this case, look at that, in the previous case, I take the random number as 0.32. Now this time I take the random number as 0.75. So we will substitute here, you will get this answer. So I will substitute here, we will calculate x1 as here. Again, it lies between the lower and upper bound. Now for the x2, you can again substitute here, but look at that, this number is not lies between minus 5 to 5, so you have to replace to their upper bound. So thus x nu will be my this. Now we will perform the greedy selection. We will calculate the function value at this new point, and we have to move for the first firefly. So what is the first firefly is this. So we compare them. So whether the f x nu, now since this is greater than, so which one is minimum? My task is to minimize. Minimum is f1, already this. So we have to preserve this. So there is no better. So there is no update the x1. So it will value keep as such. Now since there are the 5 population size, now we will compare the f1 with the f5. Now this f1 with the f5. Again f1 is greater than f5 and my task is to minimize. So we will move the f1 to the f5. So this is my xi, the next one is my xj. So we will calculate the r as this. We will calculate the beta 0 times e raised power this as here. We will calculate this random number as, now this time I take as a 0.65. So once we calculate all here, we will calculate the new value as a x1 and x2. We will get this. And all lies between minus 5 to plus 5. That is a lower and upper bound. So therefore, x nu is my here. We will perform the greedy selection. What is the value of x nu is there, and the for the first firefly my f1 is here. Now since this is better as compared to the previous one, so we will delete this value and replace by this. So look at that. Now since there is no more firefly, so we will go to the second firefly. Now we will do the same thing. We will compare f2 with the F1, F3, F4, F5. Okay, so firstly we will compare F2 with the F1. So this is my F2. So is F2 less than F2? Because my task is minimized. No. So since F2 is greater than, so we will move 2 towards the 1. Now this is my Xi. This is my now Xj. So what is my Xi is? This is my Xi. It moves towards the J. So Xi and Xj. We will calculate R. You will get this. Then you will calculate beta 0. And here. So now this time I take the random number 0.73. So after calculating this, we will substitute this value here. We will get X1 here. You can also change this random number. Look at that. In this example, I change. In this case, firstly, for the X1, I take the random number as a 0.73. For the X2, because since it is a random, it is always changed. So I take as a 0.5. So the number is -4.4850. So after calculating, you will get these numbers. So therefore, X new will be my here. We will calculate the greedy selection. Look at that. My task is for the second firefly. So we compare this with the help of this. So function value at this point is 21 point something. Original is 37. Since new value is less than, so we will update this value. So we will delete this row, second row, replace this by here. So look at that. I will here. Now you can do the same thing for the second with the third. Look at that. Can you second with the third? Second is already less than of the third, so there is no update. Second with respect to four, second is already less than of the fourth, so there is again no update because my task is to minimize. Now can F2 be less than F5? No, it is 21 and this is 4, so this is not there. So we will update the position by using Firefly. So F2 is greater than, so we will update from Xi to Xj. So this is my Xi to Xj. So we will calculate R by using Euclidean distance. We will calculate beta 0 by using this. R is here. We will calculate this time constant, this as 1.4550. So therefore we will substitute this value in this X new. We will calculate X1 as here. Then we will calculate X2 as here. And this, in this case, I will take 0.65 as a constant. So we will calculate here. So X new will be calculated as this. Perform. So we will perform the greedy selection by using this, and we will update the X2. So we will delete this X2 and replace by here. So look at that. So now since there is no more X2 are there, so we will move on the third firefly. So we will do the same thing for the third. Compare this with the first. So since F3 is greater than F1, so we will move this one. We will calculate. In this case, now this is Xi, this is Xj. We will calculate R. We will calculate these two terms are there. After substituting this value in here, we will get X1 this. We can change the value of this. Look at that. I can change the value this time for the X2. We will get this number. And X new will be here. So we will calculate the greedy selection. And my task is to compare with the third. And since this value is less than of the third, so it is better. So we will update this value. So we will delete this third row with this 3.16. Now we will compare third with the help of second. Again, third is not less than of the second, so we will move again. So we will calculate like this way. So this is my Xi, this is my Xj. We will calculate here. So we will substitute this value here. We will get these two numbers. And X new as here. Perform greedy selection. You will get these numbers. So you are in the third firefly. You compare this position with the third. So it is better. Again, we delete this number and replace this value with 1.045. Now compare F3 with the F4. So since F3 is already less than, so there is no update. F3 with F4, it is F3 is already less than of the F5. So there is no update. And since there is no more population size, so the third firefly phase is over. Now we will move on the fourth firefly. So we will compare this fourth fireflies, F4, we will compare this with the F1, F2, F3, F5. So check whether F1, F4 is less than of the, no. Look at that, F4 is greater than F1. So we will move the fireflies algorithms. In this case, this is my Xi, this is my Xj. We will calculate R. We will calculate these two terms as here. After substituting this value in this expression, we will get x1 as this. I can change this random number instead of 0.73 for the x2 as 0.45. You will get this number and get this R there. And both are lies between the lower and upper bounds are there. Okay, if it is lies outside the domain, then you have to restrict yourself to be the lower or upper bound. X new is here. Perform the greedy selection. Now you are in the fourth. So you compare this X new with the fourth position. So since 22.8080 is not better than of F4, so there is no update. So we will keep this as such. So this is 4 to 1. Now we will compare 4 to the 2. So since F4 is not better than F2, so we will again move the position. We will calculate. Now this is Xi, this is Xj. So we will calculate this as here. We will calculate this. You will get the X1 this number and X2 as this number. So therefore X new is my this. Perform the greedy selection. Compare this with the previous fourth position. You will get 3 point, which is better than of 22 point something. So we will update X4. So we will delete this line, replace by 0.9155 and so on. Now you are in the fourth. Now there is a two population are missing. So you can compare F4 with the F3. So since F4 is already better than F4, so there is no update. Now is F4 is better than F5? Yes. So again, there is no update because F4 is better than of the remaining 3 and 5. Now there is no more update, so we will move to the fifth firefly. So you can compare the fifth firefly F5 with respect to F1, F2, F3, F4. So now check whether F1 is less than of the F. Yes, so there is no update. Is F5 is less than of the F2? Yes, so there is again no update. Because my problem is minimization, that's why my task is to check whether this is less than or not. Whether F5 is less than of the F4? No. Okay, because 4.9692 is greater than of the 4.9120. This is F3, this is F5. So, we will move F5 towards the X3. So, this Xi, this is Xj. So, we will again calculate R. We will again calculate these two terms. After calculating, we will substitute here. We will get x1 and x2 are here. Therefore, capital X is my this number. Once you perform the greedy selection, you have to compare this with the fifth firefly. And the obtained number at this position is my here, and which is better than of the fifth firefly position. So we will delete this line and replace this by here. So look at that. Now we will compare F4 with F5 with respect to F4. So there is no update. Now since there is no, since my population size is the fifth, 5. So we have updated all the fireflies. So at the end of the first iteration. So now this is the end of the first iteration. We will get this updated solution. And what is the best fx is? Here. And the best solution is this number. So now this is at the end of the first iteration. Now you can do the same thing for the second iteration. What you do for the second iteration is compare F1 with the F2, F4 and so on. So whether F1, is it better than of the, yes, so there is no update. Is F1, no, this is 2, so there is greater than, so we will update it. So how you update it, now this is Xi, this is Xj. So we will do again and again same process. So once you will complete at the end of the 5 iteration, you will get this. And what is the best one is? And look at that, if you think about that, all the values are updated. And by taking this, you can perform the iteration again and again. You will get the, at the 10th iteration, you will get this. And the best solution is this, because my task is to minimize the function. At the end of the 20th iteration, you will get the minimum as here. Also, you can check that the first fitness value corresponding to the first firefly, initially 8.68, then minus 4 point, then minus 4 point, all are decreases. Okay, because my function is to minimize them. Similarly, for this second, 15, then minus 4, then minus 5, then minus, again decreases. So this is at the end of the 20 iterations. So if you want to plot the graph, you will see these are the functional of DRP. So this is a simple working procedure of this ABC, of this Firefly algorithm. If you want to compare the performance of this Firefly algorithm with the working of this PSO, ABC, you can watch these videos. With the same objective function I have considered to explain the functionality of this, you will get the better understanding. Or otherwise, you can follow this link. You will find all those related videos. So we will meet now. We will meet in the next lecture related to the MATLAB code of the Firefly algorithms. So I hope I will upload this and explain this within a one day. So if you miss any of the other videos regarding the evolutionary algorithm, you can simply browse this link. You can subscribe the channel and share the videos with your friends. And you can also find the MATLAB code of this, all those existing algorithms, PSO, ABC, TLBO, Cuckoo Search, in the same link are there. Till then, best of luck students, happy learning.